Hello everyone and welcome to new episode of LT Live. I hope all of you are doing well and thanks for joining us in the live episode. On the construction job site, I am sure you would be using a lot of chemical motors for rebarring or maybe fixing the steel structure with the help of anchor rod. And now my question to all of you is, do you struggle to find out how to select the right chemical as there are so many chemical motors available? If yes, you do not need to worry, because this is what we are going to discuss in today's episode, that how to select the right chemical while doing rebarring or maybe chemical anchoring. And to give you more insight on this topic, today with us is Rohit Tyagi, Product Manager of Chemical Anchors at Hilti India. So welcome back, Rohit, on Hilti Live. And how are you doing?
Hello, Akash. Good morning and namaste to everyone. Thank you for inviting me back again on the Hilti Live episode. I'm very excited to be back here and to have discussion with you.
Thanks, Rohit, for joining us. And now, without wasting any time, let's start with our topic. And now, my first question, a very basic question, is that many a times we discuss about rebarring and chemical anchoring. Mm-hmm. What is the difference between both?
Okay, Akash, to start with, that's a very good question. A lot of people get confused between anchoring and rebarring at a job site. So just to simplify that, I have kept something here. So whenever we are fixing a steel plate to the base material concrete, we use these kind of threaded rods. And these rods are fixed with the chemical motors. So this is what anchoring is called. Second application is rebarring. So wherever you are extending a concrete member, or wherever you are increasing the size of an existing concrete member, you use the steel rebars that are already available at the job sites. You fix these steel rebars with the mortar, and this application is called rebarring. And that's the very basic difference between anchor and rebar, Akash.
Thanks, Rohit, for clarifying the difference between rebarring and chemical anchoring. And now, moving on, I see there are a lot of chemical mortar on the table. Can you walk us through these?
Sure, Akash. So it is not only about RE500 V3 and HY200 RV3. We have a complete portfolio of mortar. And to start with, let me show you. So we have RE500 V3, we have HY200 RV3, then we have RE100, we also have HY170, we have HIT MM, and we also have RE10. For masonry specifically, we have another mortar which is HY270. So in total, Akash, we have seven different kind of mortars.
Seven different type of mortars?
Yes.
Okay. And now, Rohit, let's say tomorrow those who are watching us want to do a rebarring application on the job site. How do they select that which chemical to go for that application?
Again, a good question from you, Akash. It's very complicated to think that if we have seven different kind of mortars, how to choose which one. To simplify that, come with me, and I also welcome our audience to stay with us. So let us start with. We have five different categories which we want to discuss in next 3 to 4 minutes quickly. We talk about base material, we talk about hole type, loads and approvals of a mortar, the gel time, and what all applications it can cater to. I will start with the hero product, that is RE500 V3. This is the most lovable product of our structural consultants as well as the customers. When I talk about the base material, you can use this mortar in concrete only. And hole type, when we talk about, it can be hammer drill with the normal drill bit, or it can be diamond drill, the coring. Also in the hole type, it can be used in dry condition, in wet condition where you have some moisture in the hole, or even for the most tough condition, which is water submerged. So this can be used even in the water submerged holes. When we talk about loads and approvals, you think of a condition, and the answer is RE500 V3. Any of the toughest condition you want to execute, the solution is RE500 V3. When you have the highest level of loads, the most critical application where you need design, there can be certain examples like column extension, column from a footing, beams. RE500 V3 is the product to use. If you talk about approvals, so starting from the basic approval, which is ETA, it goes up to 100 year, seismic, fatigue, creep, long term, you think of an approval and this product has it, whatever you can think of. When we talk about gel time, so all the mortars are segmented into two categories, which is fast cure and slow cure. So RE500 V3 fits in the slow cure category, being an epoxy. Now After discussing all this, we land to the application. So any application like column extension, column from a raft, heavy beam extensions, where generally your rebar diameters starts from 1620 and goes up to 40 mm. So it has the widest range of rebar approvals, and you can also execute this with 40 mm rebar. This is all about RE500V3. Quickly jumping on to the next product that we have, HY200RV3. Talking about the base material, you can use it in the concrete base material. When we talk about hole type, you can use it in diamond drill as well as in the hammer drill. You can use it in the dry condition as well as in the wet condition. Loads, approvals, same like we discussed on RE500V3, it also caters to one of the most difficult conditions, be it rebarring or anchoring. Approvals, it also comes with 100-year approval, seismic, shock, fatigue, creep, fire, whatever you want to have, the product comes with that. When we come to gel time, then there is a difference. I told you RE500V3 is a slow cure product, but HY200RV3 is a fast cure product. So if you need a quick setting time compared to other epoxy mortars, you pick HY200RV3. Talking about applications, wherever you have your rebar diameter range starting from 16 goes up to 32 mm, that is the product to go. So this is quickly about HY200RV3. And now let me take you through the third product that we are going to discuss today, which is HY170. So again, fast cure mortar. We talk about base material. You can use this in the concrete as well as in the masonry. So this product goes on base material, which is concrete and masonry together. Hole type, if we talk about, you can use it in the hammer drill as well as in the diamond drill. When we talk about loads, approvals, it comes with the ETA approvals. It's an ETA approved product. Approvals, if we talk about, so all the basic approvals that you require to execute your basic or mid-segment application, it caters to all those. Gel time, so it's a fast cure. So let me write like this. It's a fast cure product again and comes from the HY200RV3 family. Applications. Wherever you have application, rebar diameter starting from 12, 16, goes up to 25, which can be your staircases, your cutout closures, your landings, your smaller slab extensions, you can use this product. So this is about HY170. Now I'm taking you through the last product, which is RE10. And now starting from the base material, you can use this in concrete as a base material. Hole type, it can be used in hammer drill, diamond drill both. You can use this in the dry condition, wet condition both. Loads and approval, it comes with the technical manual, Hilti technical manual, the published load data, which you can refer to. Gel time, so it's a slow cure. Let me write like this. So it's a slow cure mortar, just like RE500V3, RE100, these two. Applications, so wherever you have the non-structural application, wherever you do not require a design, wherever your rebar diameter range is 8, 10, 12, or your raw diameter is 8, 10, 12, you can use this product. Your applications can be lintel, your applications can be wall ties, shear connectors, and many other non-structural applications. This is the most cost-optimized product to go to cater to all of your non-structural anchor and rebar applications. So this is quickly about the mortar, how to pick, how to take decision quickly. We have tried to help you to take a decision basis of all this. Just filter all this and you will land to a product which you have to use. Okay, so this was all from my side. Let's go back to Akash and understand what he has to say for all of us.
So, wow, what an amazing explanation, Rohit. With that, I am sure all those who are watching us, if they need to select any chemical, they can very easily select based on the criteria that we discussed, that is base material, loads, approval, gel time, application. And now, let us quickly summarize what we discussed today. And Rohit, why don't we summarize this time a little bit different way? Maybe what we do is, you throw some question to our viewers and let's see who gets the right answer.
Sure, Akash. If you allow me to do that, I will love to do that.
So Rohit, what is the first question?
Okay. My first question is, I have an application which is a staircase. The rebar diameter is 16 mm. I do not need a design, but I need a ETA approval.
Okay. So there's a staircase, so it has to be concrete. The base material is concrete. Then the dia of the rebar is 16. We need a ETA approval, but it is not needed to be designed.
Yes.
So and what Akash, is the right answer? Let us know.
Yes. It should be fast cure.
It should be fast cure as well. So what is the right answer? Take a guess and let us know in the comment section below. And the correct answer is HY170.
Oh, you got it, Akash. So let me give you a second question. I have a super critical application. I am extending a column from a foundation, and I also have some column to column extension at the top. My rebar diameter is 25, 32, and even 40. So I need the best product that you have, and I need a slow cure because the depths will go high. I need a design, ETA, all the approvals. Which product?
Yes. So guys, now it's very critical application. The rebar dia is 20 to 40 mm. It has to be designed. And then we need a slow cured chemical.
Right.
It has to be one of the best chemicals, RE500V3.
Perfect. Last question from my side. I have a lot of non-structural applications at my job site, which comes day in, day out. They do not require any design. I just need a cost-optimized solution. I regularly have my lintels, wall ties, shear connectors, and I need a slow cure because it's a slow application. So I need a slow cure, very cost-optimized solution, Akash.
Yes. What do you recommend? Non-critical, cost-optimized, day in, day out, lintel, and all these applications. The answer is, take a guess. I know, you know, it's RE10.
Perfect. I mean, I was a good tutor then.
Yeah, you are. And thanks for being with us, Rohit, today. And guys, that's it from our side in today's episode. I hope you enjoy the live episode with my colleague Rohit Tyagi. It was an amazing experience to interact with you all. Stay tuned with us for the next episode as we both will continue the journey and wherein we will discuss how to execute the rebarring or chemical anchoring application, how you can be more productive. Thank you.